हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ जया अग्रवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर पॉलिटिकल साइंस फ्रॉम SPCGCA अजमेर। दिस इज़ पेपर 5th ऑफ MA फाइनल। नेम ऑफ द पेपर इज़ पॉलिटिकल एनालिसिस एंड रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी। एंड इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मीनिंग, ओरिजिन एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ बिहेवियरलिज्म। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्रिटिसिज्म ऑफ बिहेवियरलिज्म। सो लेट्स सी वन बाय वन। फर्स्ट वन इज, इट कंसर्न्स मोर विथ टेक्निक्स देन रिजल्ट्स। इट हैज़ बीन, दिस अप्रोच हैज़ बीन क्रिटिसाइज्ड ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट द बिहेवियरलिस्ट अटैच टू मच इम्पोर्टेंस टू द टेक्निक्स एंड मेथड्स एंड डू नॉट वरी एट ऑल अबाउट द थ्योरिटिकल इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट। Like while doing the research, the behaviorists have selected only such topics for research in which better techniques are available, and they have ignored the rest. And besides that, they have not bothered about the results. Second one is, it emphasizes the importance of behavioral effect at the cost of institutional effects. It should be noted particularly that American behaviorists have altogether neglected the effects of the institutions upon the society and concentrated their efforts only at the behavioral aspect of the individuals and groups confined mainly to America. Even the voting behavior upon which the American behaviorists lay special emphasis ignores many aspects such as the invalidation of votes on account of their being or the loss of a vote for not getting oneself registered. And third one is, study of politics can never be value free. The critics of behavioralism contend that politics can never be value free as held by the behaviorists. For example, the very selection of subjects for investigation is determined by values itself. And next one is, it emphasizes static rather than current situations. Behaviorists have been concentrating their study mainly on the static subjects rather on the current problems. In the beginning, they justified this step by saying that they were filling the gap left by the institutionalists, but now it cannot be justified as the burning problems such as the threat of nuclear war, hunger, etc. are there before the world. And next one is, difficulties in studying ever-changing behavior. It is very difficult to study the ever-changing behavior of a person because the emotions, ideas and thinking go on changing continuously. Therefore, absolutely no correct prediction can be made about the behavior of a person. Moreover, it is very difficult to measure the role of various factors governing the behavior of a person. And next one is, no emphasis on applied research. The behaviorists lay too much emphasis upon research, and regarding the political behavior of a person, but do not apply their research to the current problems, and there it is not much useful. Next one is, limited knowledge. Behavioral experiments provide only a limited knowledge regarding the political behavior of a person. It does not provide real knowledge to solve the urgent problems facing the world at large. And next one, last one is, demarcation of boundaries amongst different social sciences. There must be clear-cut boundaries as far as different social sciences are concerned, because the sociologists, anthropologists, economists and historians have no adequate knowledge of political science, and the scholars belonging to other social sciences cannot be allowed to dominate political science. And this is the all according to Professor Sibley, and who has already warned about this danger. That's all for today from my side. Thank you very much.